In this particular problem on arrays, that is problem number 3, I'm going to show you how we do simple sequential search. By the word search, we mean, suppose my array has these numbers 10, 20, 30, 40, all the way till 80 and beyond. Let us say I want to search for 40. So what it will do is it cannot directly go to 40 because it is not smart enough or it doesn't have any idea that 40 exists. So it will start looking at the first location or the zeroth location. It will compare 40 with 10. If it fails, it will go to 20. It will compare 20 with 40. It will compare 30 with 40. Finally, it will compare 40 with 40, and when the match occurs, it will say search number 40 is found and it occurs at location 4 in the array. Now let's say I look for a number like 99. Here what is going to happen is I am going to take 99 and compare it with each number 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, all the way till the end. And finally, I have looked at all the numbers and 99 does not exist or does not match with any number in the array. Then I need to print the message search number does not exist. So as usual, I have defined max of 50. That means my array is going to have 50 numbers at the most. That means starting from 0 to 49. I am not going to type in read array because I have already shown you how you can read numbers into an array. Just to refresh, this is read array. I am passing the name of the array, which is equal to the address of the array. That's why x is a pointer to an integer type of data. X contains the address of array A. So this is how internally it takes place. Then I am going to enter whatever number of numbers I want to enter into the array. Using a for loop and scanf, I am going to read all the numbers and store it in the array, and your array internally is going to look something like this. Then what I can do is, then I am going to, after reading the array, I can ask the user to enter a search number. So I have declared a variable called as search underscore num. So into that variable search underscore num, I am going to read a search number. Then if you see here, I have just shown you a prototype of the search number function. So what I am going to do here is I am going to call this function search array with these parameters. Okay, I'm just going to write it here, put a semicolon. I'm just going to substitute. I'm going to do a return 0 so that we have successfully ended. First, why is this star? Because the name of an array is an address to the particular zeroth location of an array. Next is I am sending what are the maximum numbers the user has entered. Let us see, he has entered 10 numbers, so n will be 10. And last will be the search number the user has entered. So search number is going to be sent here. Now what I'll do is I'll try to go ahead and try to type this particular function code search array, so you will get an idea of how search array is going to work. So what I'm going to do here is you will know in a short while why I have given it the value int. So let us say the address of the array is received in a variable x, okay, and then I am receiving the maximum number of elements in the array in n, and search number is copied into this variable called as int search. Then what I am going to do here is, this time I am going to declare int I is equal to 0 because I need to search from the 0th location. Then what I am going to do here is, for I equal to 0, as long as I is less than n, okay, and I am going to search every location, one location at a time, so I need to increase the value of I by 1. So here I am going to say, if x of I is equal to the search number, okay, then what I am going to do here is I am going to print the message search number percentage d found at percentage d location. Okay, now what is the search number? That is SRCH. What is the location? It will be I plus 1. Why am I doing I plus 1? Because I am starting I from 0. If I say I found something in the 0th location, person who doesn't know C programming is going to get confused. What is this 0th location? Everything starts from 1 in real life. So I am going to say search number percentage D found at percentage D location and that location. And then once I have found the search number, I need to return back to main. 0 indicates a successful search. Okay, and now there is a possibility that if I have not found the number, that means I have not been able to locate the number, then what I am going to do here is I am going to print a message. I am going to print a message like this, printf number not found. Okay, percentage, sorry, this is SRCH. So this indicates the search number is not found. Now after I print this message, I'm going to return with -1, indicate that my value was searching or my effort to search failed. If you want, you can capture this 0 and 1 in this main function here. So in main, what you can do is here, wherever you have the search array, if you define another variable x, y or z, you can say x is assigned search array and the return value can be captured. I'm just not capturing the return value. I just don't care about the return value. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to copy this program and try to run and see if it works as per my explanation. And let's see if there are any syntax or compilation time errors. So here it is. We go ahead and we copy this. All right. Let's try to run, in the sense, basically compile. Okay, we're lucky. It seems to be compiling in one shot. Number of elements into the array. Let's say we want to enter 10 numbers. Okay, so I'm going to enter 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and let us say 100. Okay, these are the numbers into my array. Okay, for some time it's lost its connection. Let's give it a try again. It's okay. So let's try to rerun it. These things happen with the online GDB compiler. It's on the cloud. You can lose your connection, which is perfectly fine. All right. So what I'm going to do now is enter the number of elements into the array 10. So I'm going to enter the 10 numbers. 10, 20, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. So these are the 10 numbers I have entered. Now what I am going to do is I am going to enter the search number. Let's say I enter 80. So it should tell me 80 exists at the 8th position. Alright. So if that is correct, then we are okay. So here if you see, based on what I explained. Alright. So I entered 10 numbers. Then the 10 numbers were these chaps here. Alright. Then I entered a search number which happened to be 80. Then based on that search, I compared 10 with 80 every time, 20 with 80, 30 with 80, 3 with 80, 40 with 80, 50 with 80, 60 with 80, 70 with 80, 80 with 80, it said found. So it said search number 80 found at 8th location. So this is the correct message you should get. Now we have found a search number. Let's try running it and see if it doesn't find a search number, assuming the search number does not exist. Let's say we enter only 8 numbers, okay, and I'm going to enter the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So I've entered 8 numbers. Now it's asking me to enter the search number. Let me enter the search number as 99. So the message it should say is search number 99 not found. So 99 search number not found, indicating that 8 numbers, these were the 8 numbers entered. Search number was 99 and 99 number was not found because I did not enter 99 as any of these input numbers. So this should give you a good idea about how do you do simple sequential search in an array. There is something called binary search. You will either learn it during this semester or when you come to data structures. It's a very, very important way of searching, and we'll be hopefully trying to give you a brief idea at some point of time.